All right, we've ripped off the band-aid. We've hit that vaunted 90%. Now there's basically nothing to do but actually step in and do the race. Let's see what we got. Well, I'm just going to run that time down a little bit here and allow us to benefit from some track gripping. And maybe rebound some form too. Just kind of trying to calculate the ideal qualifying run. You should be under that temperature in the operating window. Apparecio splits the chariots. And they arrive just behind Z. Man, a little qualifying boost, and maybe we're there. There's a huge gap. And I'm just kind of hoping it gets better. Leroy, finding a couple tenths would be nice, but I don't really expect it. Sarah's not going to improve. He said it doesn't look like she is at the moment. Aparicio does, but not by a ton. It's race time. We got rain coming at about lap 25. Temperatures are not great. Tires about 30 laps. My strategy is to basically get the things seamlessly into the rain period. And we'll push the car from the start and yeah. I should have tried to sign him as a number two driver. That's gonna... I might implement a new upgrading philosophy that makes the cars closer to equal. My hope would be to eliminate this perception of inequality. These guys are pushing early on the soft tire. The upshot for us, we know those tires are not going to last. I just need Sarah Leroy to just emerge as, like, a legit driver this season. Ooh, looks like we're going to get a very, very sharp increase in rain. Yeah, Leroy is finishing the last race has convinced me to depend on her as top driver, or at least to make the attempt. Yeah, I was trying to make a little bit more of a push. Oh, yeah. My intention, I think, is going to be to go straight to the wet tire. Aparicio probably is going to improve pretty quickly. But the term of his contract is the same as Alvarez's was, so we'll have him through what the rest of Alvarez's contract would have been. These teams are improving in the areas that like a lot of these races need, and we're improving for races that aren't emphasizing the components we're improving yet. Maybe enters. It looks like there's ample opportunity for a computer screw up, which I'm more than happy to see. But I'm planning a drastic increase to the rear aerodynamics. The marginal improvements we're making are not really making a mark. So I really want to make a mark, I suppose. Yep, these cars are never making it. It looks like it's a long pit lane too, so. That is going to work in our favor. Turn the engine up and get this move done. Becker is just fighting the move hard. Dang it. Oh well. We are kind of starting to close in. Yeah, we're seeing some stops now. These cars could potentially pose future problems for me. We'll just have to see. Now we do get some Windsors in the pits. Mordai didn't even... The plot thickens, it does. Leroy is into a points paying position. I think intermediate tires. There's going to be a wet period, but I don't know if it's going to be long enough to justify even putting the tires on. It's one of those situations where you need to kind of visualize it in your mind. We do take beach, and we got Nitro kind of on us. And he's more or less too fast, so... This is just going to be a matter of correctly reacting to the weather, I think. Which looks like we're going to be seeing rain for the remainder. But if cars do react and go into wet tires, then we will have a lot of opportunity here. And they may react, seeing that far, only that far ahead. Okay, let's react as if our practical run is going to be on intermediates. I think it will, and that's not going to change. And Beach is kind of slinking the move now. Unless we get better braking, which we don't. So we just need to get ourselves ready to react to the weather change. There it is. Just the key thing is not to react too early. I'm thinking we just bring him in on lap 25. The main thing to timing this is to make sure we nail it. We got, yeah, it's gonna be like 20 laps. I hear you. Yeah, let's get them in. Couple of guys did spring for wets. Carbone going onto the wets is a race-losing decision, I think. Oh, they're reacting. Uh-oh. I ain't so sure anymore, because this is kind of a decent length of time. that the bar is actually moving. Yeah, when we get here, I think the rain's already going to be starting to lighten. We're going to stay confident. Even though this could end up hurting. But I think this might bear out to being the correct move. Because now the rain's basically done. The rain's gonna get about here, and the speeds are gonna change. My guess is that the AI is gonna panic and not react right away, but they might. Some of them are reacting right away, actually. Which actually will be kind of smart. We are now faster. The only thing that's kind of an unknown, based on my own use of the tires, the intermediates are going to last 16 at best. So he might actually have earned another pit stop advantage. Maybe it wasn't a race-losing decision. Jeez. Carbone has some parts malfunctioning. And I would say these tires could make it to the end, except for this little dip. Is going to wear the inners a little bit quicker, I think. That might make it impossible for them to otherwise finish on this tire. Just one of those little things. Some of these guys may even try out dry tires. Alright, well, we go into this pit lane. We're seeing everyone pit again. Thank you. You want to take it easy till the water reaches a certain level. Maybe one more like this. We'll turn up our car now. Now it's all about how quickly we can negotiate the Warren Windsor. Banking that car, surely. Overcooking it. Catching who is going to be difficult. We're really just trying to outdo Beach. But I think he's going to have a very hard time finishing on this tire. They're really going to be able to nurse that tire? Maybe. We got Naito knocking on our door. Crap. I don't really want to let him by, actually. Just don't feel like letting him by. You know, let the rest of this race play out. Shoot. Alright, please hold, Leroy, please hold. Beach is going to somehow manage to finish that the race. Which is a little annoying. Because I think we had the position to beat that car. Hashtag wins are lucky. Those tires do not clip, unfortunately. They clip at like 5% or something like that. We just need to get faster. I feel like I'm saying that every episode now, but it is still true. Well, hang on to the points we do score. Overtaking Windsor is not going to be easy, like properly. And Catano. It's kind of what we're trying to do right now. Okay, that race was fine. Got some points. I stopped short of doing a legendary engine. I still have faith that I'm going to get anything but, like, a reliability upgrade at this point out of Legendary. Alright, he likes the morale. Boom. Rear wing built. Sponsorship coming up. And... Dale, I need Marine Key in your seat to attract the sponsors. You know, we have another guy that is burned out. So we would get to 1690, which is not nothing. Build it. Reject, continue, bam, bam, bam. Bing, boom, bam. Rear wing. Let's finish the engine first. And then we'll just stick these wings in. I'm curious about staff. That's a weird perk. It doesn't always work. It does plug our financials a little bit. Drivers. What's our next race? Munich. Which... That's a tough race for everybody. So yeah, this would be the time to give Aprascio the better car as well. Don't really... Yeah, engine's fine. New month. Rear wing finito. So then we just say we dump that one. That'll be the last one we design, regardless of whether it bears fruit or not. And we'll actually want to stop developing that one too. And then I'll probably work on front wings next. I've actually changed my mind on the number one driver thing. I think we can treat him like a number two, and as long as he finishes well enough, it doesn't matter who has the better car. Kind of fool him. Because he sees the engine. I mean, it will eventually be slightly better, I guess. Anyway, let's jump in. See you guys on the jump here on the next part.